After listening to Vanati's words mixed with laughter, the prince also got down from the elephant laughing. Aha! Climbing an elephant is a very difficult task. It is like climbing a royal throne. Climbing an elephant is difficult, sitting on it is difficult. Descending from an elephant is difficult of all. Yet one has to experience those difficulties sometimes. Said Ponniyin Selvan. Some go through the trouble for the most trivial of reasons. There are those who run on elephants to save baby birds. Vanatha said. Do you still remember that incident, Vanati? I thought you might have forgotten it because you didn't talk about it until today. Said the prince. Those who wander around the world and engage in many heroic deeds will forget. What else does the demon woman in the palace have to do but remember it? She remembers when she came riding on an elephant that day, she remembers when she said I was a woman of Kajumbalar and turned away with a frown. There was a reason for that then, Vanathi. That reason is still there, sir. You are the son of the world's emperor, the son of the jewel of Cholavaland. Born and raised in the wild region of Nanopatai. The clan of a minor king, and even more so, the orphaned daughter of one who died in battle. Vanati. You are doing me injustice. You are saying unfair words. Let me go. I must go to Tanjore in a hurry. Tell me quickly. How did you come here? Why did you come alone? Did you come floating on the roof? Why did this girl come here? How did she get stuck in such a predicament? I'm glad they remember me standing here alone. If I give you a minute to speak alone, I'll say what I have to say and leave. Said Punghuali. As the two women stood face to face in front of the prince at that moment, they somehow possessed extraordinary courage and modesty. Say Madrakumari. Did you think I had forgotten you? How could that be? You are the one who steered the boat without even stopping to answer my calls. I will never forget that she came so hastily and stood swinging between the tree branch and the crocodile's open mouth. After saying that, the prince laughed. Nor will I forget the misery of Vanati holding you up, unable to lift you. But how did you two end up here? What for? Somebody tell me, quick. Ponniyin Selvan. We have come to prevent anyone from going to Tanjavur to prevent them from going to Tanjavur with their son. Ilaya Prati fears that a big war will break out there if they come to Tanjavur. Before that, the young man wants to meet and talk. Where is the young brat now? In child. How did you get here alone? On the way, I and the younger bratty stayed for a while at the house of the child astrologer. At that time the Kaveri burst its banks and swept away the house of the astrologer. Prince. They say that the mother of the Kaveri saved them in childhood. I know how much they desire this golden river. But today because of this river the country, the cities, the people, and the animals are horrified to think of the suffering. It seems to say that Mother Kaveri is very cruel. Vanati. Don't blame Mother Kaveri like that. This Madarazi has so much desire for our Chola country. When that desire goes beyond the limit, she breaks the bank and leaves. Those who do not know this blame the mother in vain. Why? Some people even blame Samatharaja for breaking the bank. She won't complain. Said the prince. Excuse me. I am not blaming Mother Kaveri anymore. When I and their son were in the astrologer's house, suddenly Kaveri's desire flared up. They ran away and climbed on the temple hall. I failed to climb on the hall because of my confusion. I floated by holding the roof of the astrologer's house. Pungazalai came to the boat to save you. It's beautiful. This Gayendra had to save both of you. This elephant's knowledge is knowledge. It took you two without being surprised as if it were picking up a flower garland due to its praise and left it on the shore a while ago. This morning this same elephant picked up the elephant that was running away with Angusa in its hand and spun it to fall far away. Throne. It's rare that he survived. Oh. What is it? I wanted to ask them about it myself. What did you want to ask me? I wanted to ask if any harm had come to them, whether it was an elephant or an anguja. It's true that there was a bad time, how did you know that? Did the astrologer say, what? Hasn't that mad young brat gone yet? The astrologer didn't say it. We wouldn't believe it if he did, said the Great Reaper. What? What? Who said that? Yes, Prince. It was the officer who said it. We were in the astrologer's house when he burst in. He told us about the danger that might befall them. He also told us about the poisoned Angusam. Aha! This is a great miracle. How did he know? Did he become an astrologer too? Or maybe? Did he arrange this himself as everyone says? No, Prince. It was not his arrangement. He overheard what the Pandya conspirators were talking about secretly. Oko. Did he say anything else? Terrible to think and say. They said that the conspirators planned to send them, their father, and the eldest prince, Aditha Kari Kalar, to Yamanila on the same day. He hastened to Kadapur to save Aditha Kari Kalar. He left saying that Ilai Apradi should warn them and the emperor. Aga. As his warning was true in the case of one of me, it must be true in the case of others too. Samudra Kumari. Do you want to say something? Yes, Prince. The Mute Queen of Elam has sent me to bring them to Tanjore at once. Aha! I forgot to ask you about that. It was for the Queen of Elam that I left in such haste. Did someone forcefully drag her to Tanjavur? Is that true? True, sir. But Prime Minister Anuruddha did so with good intentions. Oko. Anuruddha's work? Must have been taken to my father to be added. Pungujali. Did the Prime Minister's mission succeed? Did they, the Emperor and the Queen of Elam, meet? Yes, they met. My life's wish has been fulfilled. I have no happier news than this. As long as my great-grandmother is near, my father's life is not in danger. You know that Madarasi has a rare future, Punguzali. Yes, I know that. The Emperor is in no danger as long as the Queen of Elam is present. But what? Why are you hesitating, Samathera Kumari? It's hard to say, I'm not up. The Queen of Elam thinks her end is near. She wants to see herself once before she closes her eyes for the last time. She said. God! What are you talking about? You tell me happy news and then tell me this terrible news. I will not delay for a moment, Vanathi. Tell the young man that I have apologized. Said Prince Arulmas Hivarmar.